Hi, I'm Ezekiel. Today, I'm going to talk on microphone comparison on a dynamic microphone SM58 and a condenser microphone AKG-C3000, which are going to compare with each other, and we are going to bring out the advantage of each microphone on the talking drum. But in this video, I'm going to put us through the frequency response of SM58 and the AKG-C3000. Alright now, before we move on, I want you to please subscribe to the channel and press the notification button so you'll be the first person to be notified whenever I upload any video like this. And I want us to keep the discussion continuous by leaving the comment below. Let's share from your experience over any microphone which you might have used to capture the talking drum. General specification of AKG-C3000. Audio frequency 20 Hz to 20 kHz, which is good. In audio standard, it captures anything. That is the main thing. So it has the electrical impedance 200 ohms, recommended load 1000 ohms, which is very good. Let me take us through the frequency chart. It has a gentle slope from 50 Hz downward, which is good for us. It's very, very good to capture the frequency spectrum of the talking drum at 50 Hz, which is very good. So it's having about almost 5 dB plus from the 55 to 60 Hz to 800 Hz, which makes the 3000 to be more robust and low cut from 2 kHz. And from 4 to 6 kHz, it's having a nice boost up to 10 kHz and a plus 5 dB on 15 kHz, which is very, very good for us. So it's more of an advantage to us to capture anything from our talking drum. SM58 specifications. SM58 frequency response from 50 Hz to 15 kHz. This is of less advantage to us to capture anything below. There's something more that I'm going to show you on SM58 frequency response chart. So 50 Hz to 15 kHz, though, it's still good. It's very, very nice for live application. It captures well. And output impedance compared to the C3000, this one is having 300 ohms. The sensitivity also 1 kHz. So let me go to frequency response of SM58. SM58 is having a gentle cough from, let me say, from 110 to having gentle cough. Then by the time it gets to 50 Hz or above, or 60 or 55 Hz, there won't be any efficiency on that frequency for our talking drum if you are using it, especially when the talking drum is playing down deep into the low frequency, which they love mostly to hear. When the talking drum is going deep down, this one cannot deliver what we really want. But for the live applications, I use SM58 so much. I love it so much. And from the high frequency side, from 3K to 7K, it has about plus 5 dB, and up to 10K, about 9K, having about 9 dB up to 10 dB also, which is also nice for our talking drum. Gives a nice high-end. So this is about the SM58. So lastly, look at it. On my right hand, I have SM58 frequency response chart. And on my left side, I have a C3000 frequency response chart here. So like what I want to compare on this chart, look at SM58. It's having slow cough from above 110 Hz, gentle cough downward. So anything from 100, anything from 105, 100 Hz is almost waste. Look at C3000. Its gentle cough start from 55 Hz downward, so which still retain the frequency response which we need for the talking drum which we are talking about. So this is more of advantage to us. And anything below that it can still capture it for us very well. But SM58, anything below 100, it can deliver a great job for us. Right now, we'll go into the practical experiment. Let's see the advantage of both microphones on their frequency response, what they sound like on the talking drum, and how they respond well to the mix. So let's go into that and see what's going to happen there. Here now, I'm having the two wave clips of the two talking drums. Upper here, on the red color, I'm having the KGC3000. The brown color, I'm having SM58. So now with this, I'm gonna play to you while you listen to the way both of them sound naturally without any plugins. And I'll show you something here. This is something I did here to make sure I have the same level. Let me bring out the second one. So on my left side, this WLM it's my peak analyzer for the both of them. On my right side, I'm using this one to show the level to make sure I have virtually almost the same level. Let me just play the talking drum. Let's listen to them. I'll alternate between the two so you listen to them. You can see we have virtually the same range, the same level. Up here is AKGC3000. Down here is SM58. Look at the parameter settings. On SM58, low frequency is lost, I regain it back. On C3000, high frequency 4K is lost, and I try to gain it back. So now I balance the two microphone frequency response to sound equal, then I'll build my mix on them. I'm starting the mix now with stage 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's just listen to the way it sounds like on the talking drum. With the way TG12345 sound like now, I'm good with that. I'm not doing much. Just want to check how the talking drum is sound like on C3000 or for the talking drum. So I'm loading up on program EQ by Wave also. Thank you. this is just it. Let me just explain what I did on the PG equalizer. At 60 hertz, I'm just boosting around 2 dB, then attenuating around 4 dB to reduce the rumbleness from the low end of the talking drum to give a clean, smooth low end in that section. Then the bandwidth, I'm just trying to expand, spread around all the frequency on the talking drum. Then on the high mid, I started from 3K to see how it sounds like. That one is sounding relatively to the talking drum itself, acoustically when you hear it. And then I'm also switched to 8K to 10K. When I switched to 12 to 16K, you could just hear the kind of harshness, that there's no sweet spot, there's no reality on that talking drum high end. To me, in my opinion, it won't give me a nice, crispy, and rhythmic response from that frequency on the talking drum. So I'm just trying to, to be partial a bit, so I'm stopping on 10K and 10K to just boost 10K up to 5 dB to make it sound more tight on the high end, and we'll still have in depth, sound rigid, and still sound more heavy and sound tight. And for me, then on the transformer button, what I did there, I switched to 50 hertz. It enhanced the low end to still retain the tightness from the low end size. So with the plugin I'm loading up now is DPR-402. It's a clean, nice compressor. So I'm gonna walk all through it. So let us hear the way this one sounds, the way it makes my talking drum tight on AKG C3000. I really don't have to do much on this because my mix from the first EQ to the second EQ and to this one makes my mix tight, and I love the talking drum, the way it sounds. It's not until it sounds boomy, boom, 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 like I don't do that. This is nice for me, it's clean. I can hear, I can feel the low end, I can also feel the top end, the mid side, it's okay for me, everything is balanced to me. One of the things I do in my mix is I only want to add a little saturation onto it. I'm applying a cakewalk tube a little. Okay, now after being done with C3000, so what I'm going to do now, I already created a preset on each plugins that I use for C3000, which I'm going to load on SM58. So by loading that, I'll start the mix from there. So I want to see how each microphone will be able to respond to mix very easy. Look at AKG C3000, I already have my preset saved on it, so which I'm going to upload. First thing, let me upload the preset which I already created. That's it for now. I'm gonna load on PTEC EQP1A, then I'll upload the same preset on it. So let us hear the way this one too is gonna sound like on it. this one, I think I can't go beyond the threshold, but I'll go just with that. But it's still giving me a nice response, which I still want, but compared to that. So after all, I'll play everything, the two together, will compare. Next thing I'm going to upload down is the DPR 404. What I'm gonna do is, I want to play the two talking drum. We'll listen to C3000. We also listen to SM58. So we listen to the way they sound and compare to each other. I'll play all through the sections. We'll play the both talking drums together. Let's just listen to that.